A lot of people are afraid of the procedure and are scared of the procedure, which is understandable. It's still general surgery. It's still a surgery, and but given the relatively sort of small nature of this procedure, most people are surprised of how well the recovery is going when we meet them back a week after surgery. So it's generally the tenor is that people said, well, this wasn't a big deal.
Amen to that.
Sweated it out.
My surgeon said with what he was going to do with me, he has incurred none of those complications. None. He's done over 1,000 of these. So the odds of something going wrong for me seemed very low and very acceptable.
If you'll have a seat.
So first, when patients have this hearing loss, and they're usually referred to us by an outside either audiologist or ENT or even their primary care doctor, we use a hearing aid to test the patient's hearing at that time. And that will really tell us the best aided condition, we call that, which of course reflects the patient's hearing with his or her hearing aids. And that aided speech testing or aided hearing testing will really tell us whether someone's a candidate or not. Once that's complete, there is also a medical evaluation process. We just make sure that the middle ears are okay, that the patient has no other medical conditions that would preclude cochlear implantation. And we typically do obtain a CT scan, in some cases an MRI.
You can see the hammer bone, the anvil bone.
So it will sit behind your ear, just like that.
Okay.
And then it will communicate to the inside piece via that magnet.
The surgery requires general anesthesia. It takes about an hour and a half to do the procedure, or sometimes even less. It requires a cut behind the ear. It's about a 2-inch cut behind the ear, or 5-centimeter cut behind the ear. And overall, it's a very safe procedure. We do really consider general health, of course, as a factor in all this. But typically speaking, there is no upper age limit for cochlear implantation. And compared with hip replacement, I would argue that cochlear implantation is much less surgery and much less recovery.
I like that little
idea. Isn't that nice?
I like this.
Our ideal clinical timeline is really to see the patient back a week after implantation. And if everything goes well, we can proceed annual appointments at that point.
I know a lot of people are concerned about the pain of surgery. I had very little. It wasn't difficult.
And he just put in the magnet, and I came out with a turban. And for a few days, I wore this turban that was just simply to hold the swelling in, but very little pain. And in fact, no pain that I can really remember.
Operation, the post-op, no problem. They put an ear brassiere on this side to cover, you know, the wound while it was healing for a few days. Uncomfortable, but not that big a deal. And that lasted about a week. After that, it's just feels fine.